You don't necessarily need real gear to interconnect legacy operating systems. This goes as well in emulation using 86-box and VDE, the virtual distributed Ethernet switch, which also provides you with capturing support. Let's talk about legacy network technology. The older your software base gets, the less helpful the usual suspects like VMware and VirtualBox will be due to compatibility issues. This is where 86-box shines, giving you an emulation capability for PC compatibles from around 1981 to the late 90s. 86-box also includes a broad variety of emulator network cards, which comes in handy if you want to play around with older network-capable operating systems. And while of course you could bridge the emulated machines onto the real physical network, this may not always be desirable. At least on macOS and Linux, that's no big deal, however, as 86-box supports VDE, the virtual distributed Ethernet switch. Using VDE, it's possible to create a self-contained virtual switch that just sits between the emulated machines. Perfect for playing around. As I'm using the Mac for the most, I had to install the VDE first. This can be done by means of Mac ports or Homebrew, the latter of which I'll be using here. But don't worry, the 86-box wiki also explains how to do this on Linux. I then created a short shell script that I can easily fire up whenever I need the VDE running without requiring me to memorize the extensive command line. When running the VDE switch, you'll be automatically connected to the switch console, which provides you with some status and configuration commands. Then check the network settings of the VM and set the network card to VDE mode. Don't forget to provide it a path to the control socket so the VM can attach to the VDE switch. Once connected to the VDE, you can query the port status like this. And at this point, the story could be over and it all works perfectly fine, correct? Wrong! When playing around with Windows for workgroups, my VMs simply didn't seem to communicate with each other.
You surely had an IP address configuration error.
Nah, there was no IP involved at all, as I simply ran NetBUI over NetBIOS Frames protocol. And as NBF doesn't really provide for diagnostic tools, I had the strong desire to hook up Wireshark to the VDE switch in that very moment in order to see what's going on with the virtual wire. There's a neat tutorial describing how to enable capturing on VDE, but guess what? The required plugins are not compiled into the Homebrew version. So I had to specifically direct Homebrew to fetch the source, but also to bypass API-based source downloads. I then edited the configuration formula file, adding the --enable-experimental flag before recompiling and reinstalling it again. I then expanded said shell script I created before to support capture mode on request. This works by creating a FIFO upfront where the PCAP stream will be sent to. You also need a configuration file, which adds the default startup commands to enable capturing mode and pass it to the VDE switch command on startup. Don't forget to fire up Wireshark before starting the VDE switch. This is necessary because, as by definition on how FIFOs work, the program writing to the FIFO will stall for as long as there is no consumer reading from the FIFO. That's why Wireshark must be launched beforehand. Mind though, this is the macOS syntax. When using Linux, you will need to adapt this accordingly. Funny story. The moment I fired up my freshly compiled VDE switch and had the VMs booted as well, all VMs started communicating with each other right away and Wireshark would process the captured network packets. And, given all plugins being available now, there's now traffic counters available, which is of great use already, to spot if there's some ingress and egress traffic in the first place. So, obviously, there is no problem in communication, at least at this point. One might assume the original package I had installed from Homebrew had a bug. But after removing my custom version and trying again with the official release, I couldn't reproduce the problem any longer. At least, I now have a custom version on macOS that supports capturing, which certainly will become handy in my upcoming trials on legacy networking products. Of course, to spare the extra efforts on Homebrew as shown, try using Mac ports instead. This has a directly installable variant with the experimental plugins already available. What do you think about it? Let me know in the comments below. I'm the Vintage Collector and this was my story for the day. Thanks for watching and see you again next time. Next on the Vintage Collector. So we previously looked into Windows Home Server Netgear's SC101, two small office home office storage products emerging from the mid-2000s era when things were meant to become easier than ever to configure for consumers. But was it really all that hard 10 years prior? Let's find out as we jump back into the early 90s to build a small workgroup network using Windows for Workgroup 3.1.